Ladies and gents, hello and welcome. My name, of course, is Obito Potato. This is Civilization 6. We are getting closer to A, having a thermonuclear device. Not like that's really the main aim, but also we're doing really, really, really well in terms of achieving our space goals and becoming a space power or whatever. Let's just go ahead and beat up the enemy a little bit, because why not? Yeah, there's no way that they can survive. And let's also set up some trade routes, because we are going to get shit tons of money for trading with international civilizations, thanks to a policy that we just introduced at the end of the last episode. I would thoroughly, thoroughly recommend that you watch if you are interested, because boy, oh boy, was it a big one. We got globalization, we got the globalization civic, which was huge. Boom, let's get that builder to do something over there. Also, that looks like uranium to me. It looks like our territory expanded out to that uranium. It was a little bit further than three tiles. One, two, three. Yeah, so it was a fourth tile away, which means that you can only get it by expanding borders, not by purchasing it, which I was looking to do, but I couldn't. We got globalization, and we got e-commerce, super, super good. We also get plus 50% tourism output to civilizations with which you have a trade route. And let me tell you, I have very, very carefully made it so that we have a trade route with everyone. So that means we now get a shit ton of tourism from everyone. Or we are giving everyone a bunch of tourism or whatever. Egypt is on their way to the space victory, but I am way further along than they am. Than they are, should I say. Science victory we're leading, culture victory we are leading, religious victory we're leading. I don't really believe that. That's not really true. I mean, Arabia is actually doing better in faith per turn than me, but at the same time, you can just go to sleep here, actually. At the same time, Arabia has promised not to convert any of my cities, so as long as they maintain that promise and don't convert any of my cities, then we're going to have a great relationship. We're going to have an absolutely great relationship. Egypt has sent an envoy to Candy. I think that that sounds like a stripper name personally, but who am I to judge? Egypt, you may do as you please. Nothing I shall not. This earth lasts forever, I shall not tell you what to do. Except maybe plastic. Unlocks the builder ability to build an offshore rig. Can only be built on oil. Well, let me tell you that I have no sea tiles that are actually worth a damn. And I mean literally no sea tiles that are actually worth a damn. I mean, if you look around, crabs. Crab, that's it. That's all we have. That's all we have. Okay, bunch of peace. Cool. City starving. Chennai does not have enough food. Which it should have enough food, but fingers crossed. How much food does it actually need? Minus 5 food. Okay, so we need to set up with the trade route that actually has, that gives plus 5 food. Which I don't think, yeah, there's no international trade routes that give plus 5 food, so we're gonna have to, unfortunately, set it up with a domestic trade route. Not like that's a particularly big deal. In fact, it doesn't actually matter. We're gonna send some mechanized inventory up to here because Mr. Congo, even though we are technically friendly, he is a little bit worrisome in terms of what he's actually doing. We've also got a great artist that we've got sitting around, Vincent van Gogh, or Gogh, or however the hell you say it. And to do that, we need to build something that actually gives us great work slots. Great works of art slots, specifically. So the Hermitage would be one. 30 fucking turns, though? I can't build for 30 turns. We just gotta keep on going for campus research grants, quite frankly. Because there is no way on God's green earth that I'm gonna spend 30 turns building the Hermitage. I mean, the game will probably be over in 30 turns. I mean, that's maybe a little bit ambitious, but 30 turns is just, that's a no from me, I'm afraid. How are we doing in the great scientist department? 4,800 patronage we need to get Carl Sagan. He gives us 3,000 production towards the Space Race construction project, which is super, super cool. We're launching our moon landing in 3 turns. That's pretty fucking big in terms of the tech tree. We're still researching all the stuff that we actually need to get to Mars, but we're most of the way there. I mean, we've got robots, which is 5 turns. Four turns, eight turns, 10 turns. Ah, we're like 30 turns away. Pretty much exactly 30 turns away, actually. We could declare war on someone if we really wanted to be a shit stick. But I don't really know if that's my style. I'm just going to continue sending my troops out this way because I think the last time I saw Jerusalem was having a little bit of a problem with the barbarians. So I'll see if I can rectify that situation and perhaps give them a little helping hand. A little bit of a helping hand. All right. Greece did have a settler over here and I worried for a little bit that they were going to place a city down here. I think they would be able to. It's far enough away from everything. But if they did, they would get that uranium, and that would make Greece actually a nuclear power if they ever managed to produce any nuclear weapons, because they have, like, three sources of uranium, which is fairly impressive. Okay, just keep on building those campus research projects. Or campus research grants, even. That's all we really care about. Mechanized infantry, yeah, we're gonna send you up here. You're gonna get up there in three turns, fantastic. Machine gun. We're gonna put you on the border. Fuck me, these are armies. These are well thought out armies. Well thought out armies. A well developed army, that's what I mean to say. A well developed army. Is there anything that we can build in our theater? I mean, what is the palace that gives us the great art slot? That's terrible, actually. That's really bad. That is unbelievably bad for us. If I build a theater district up here, it's gonna take eight turns, but we might be able to get something. I think if we built a museum, would that give us what we need? The problem is that the theater square here, you have to choose between a regular old museum and an archaeological museum. And we've so far taken an archaeological museum in both Manjuria and Delhi. So, yeah, basically a regular museum might have art slots. I just have no idea. Uranium, we're getting a second source of uranium. Hallelujah, that's great. Operation Ivy is 13 turns away, which is going to give us thermonuclear weapons, whatever the heck that is. And apparently, we can build a tourist resort over here, which I didn't even realize we could do to increase tourism. Sign me the fuck up to that. I will take that any day of the week. I mean, admittedly, it is kind of ironic that one of my cities that I have geared specifically around production seems to be building a nuclear, thermonuclear test lab or whatever, and has a power plant and has very big naval war capabilities. I find that silly how that would be a nice tourist spot. What does it even do? Build improvement seaside resort. It just gives us gold? Alright, well that's... I mean, that's alright. I'll take it. It's not the best. It's not the worst. It's rather middling, actually. 26 turns to build the hermitage here. Again, not super bothered about it. But we do have a bomber, which is kind of cool now. Our one single bomber. That's all right, I suppose. Keep on going with those campus research grants. We're getting there. We are getting there. Builder, you can build a pasture here. Do we still have a pasture on this stinking farm over there? All right, we'll go for it. You'll fortify. This bomber is going to, WMD strike or thermonuclear device. Okay, so we got air attack, nuclear device, and a thermonuclear device. I want to use them, right? I want to use both of them. But I want a thermonuclear device more than I want a nuclear device, because, I mean, that seems only logical, right? Like, thermonuclear is better than nuclear. It's gotta be. It's gotta be. There's no point in getting a thermonuclear weapon that is worse than a nuclear weapon. That'd be a little bit silly. Egypt is actually remarkably far on this tech tree. Like, so much so that it's actually making me a little bit worried. Egypt, technology 104. We're 122, so we're a little bit ahead of them, but in terms of technology. But we're miles ahead of everyone. Arabia is the biggest threat, and... Oh! A space race project has been completed. Perfect. Launches a large rocket to land a human on the moon, grants a one-time culture bonus equal to 10 times your science per turn, and marks the second step towards the space victory.
There's so much plastic in this.
Your army is at our doorstep. Do you think we are blind? My troops are merely passing by. Do not worry, my friend. Do not worry. Yeah, so we are going to get a shit ton of... I have no idea how much culture we got. It was probably in the region of like 1,000, 2,000 science or whatever it was. One, two, three. Three civics completed. Lovely, lovely, lovely. I was away to say, what is Arabia's biggest bonus coming from? Technology that are on 104. We're on 124, so they mostly get it from the size of their empire, I think. Yeah, they've mostly got it because of the size of their empire. Which is fine, you know, they've got an alright empire. Our empire is still miles better, but... there you go, I suppose. 14 turns for the Hermitage. I would love to. I would dearly, dearly love to, but... We've got to build the Mars reactor. We really, really do. Can we get Carl Sagan yet? Next turn. So close. So close to Carl Sagan. Your international trade routes provide one gold per luxury strategic resource improved at the destination. That sounds like a really, really good idea. Should we get rid of heritage tourism? Get rid of market economy? Yeah, let's do it. 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 And let's see. We've got 102 cash right now. Oh, we need another slot because apparently we ran out of great people or whatever. Great merchant points, great engineer points, great scientists. Four great scientist points per turn, actually, please. That would suit me rather nicely, even though we are about to run out of great scientists. The reason that we couldn't, the reason that we had a missing wildcard policy slot there is because we got an upgrade on our great scientist points per turn card, whatever that was, and it basically meant we needed to get two instead of one. Or we get double, not two instead of one, four instead of two, which is double the great scientist points per turn, which makes the old card redundant, which gave us two great scientist points per turn. Stop spying on me has been fulfilled. Great. Let's go to the next turn. 11 turns till thermonuclear, and 21 turns until Mars reactor. Not too shabby, if I do say so myself. Build two field cannons. Do we not have two field cannons? Like, that seems a little bit ridiculous. I guess I'm going to form a core. Save a little bit of cash and do something. Which is perhaps wasteful, I guess. Maybe it's better to not have them in a core. I don't really know. I haven't really gone to war with the mechanized infantry at all. Really? You're annoyed at me? Really? Converted one of their cities. Are you shitting me? Like, how broken is this game if it's telling me that I converted their cities? But I didn't convert their cities. I mean, yeah, sure, I converted them like fucking 10 years ago, but not since then, I'm afraid. And I haven't actively done it. I haven't done it out of malice. I have got an absolute stranglehold on all of the religion on this continent, though. Which is working out relatively well for me, considering that's something that I quite like. Can I not build a seaside resort here? Why could I build one here? If I buy a tile, that one, which may be a little bit of a waste. Can I build a seaside resort right here? I guess not. Fuck me, right? Can we get Carl Sagan? Yes, we can. Oh my god. Carl Sagan, come here, boy. Come here. You're gonna go down to this spaceport next turn. Oh my god. It's gonna be good. We're gonna get shit tons of production. And it's gonna be fantastic. How much production do we still have to do of this? Yeah, we've got like 2,600. Which I think we'd probably burn like a tiny little bit of Carl Sagan. But I think, and mostly it's not going to be a waste. Not going to be a waste at all. Friendship or scorched earth. Wow, that's a little bit vicious. Settler cost reduced by 50%. Plot purchase cost reduced by 20%. Yields gained from pillaging are doubled. Well, that's just bloody great, isn't it? Alright, Carl Sagan. I'm just going to transfer you to this city, and then you can go next turn. Oh, we can totally build a seaside resort right there, which may or may not do anything for tourism. Also, there is a Greek minivan. That's the first time that I've seen that in ever, actually. Fucking Greek minivan. You've accumulated enough faith to purchase an inquisitor. Well, that's fucking fantastic. And what's his name finished our hermitage. So that's a little bit of a problem. Well, I say problem. It's not really a problem, actually. More just a minor setback. What do I need? I don't need anything here. Probably just science, to be honest. Not like it particularly matters. We're doing very well for ourselves in terms of science. We're doing very, very well. In fact, we're doing very well for ourselves in terms of everything, actually. I don't think there's a single category in which we are somewhat lacking, except maybe the military department. But honestly, who is going to declare war against someone who is pretty much at the end of technological advancement? Is that even possible to be at the end of technological advancement? I think it is. And we are pretty much there. If Mr. Congo wants to declare war on me, I will probably just nuke his socks off. Admittedly, I won't be able to get a nuke for like 8 turns, but it's going to take him 8 turns to capture the city anyway. And by that time, I'd be able to build a nuke. All right, let's head you over here, Carl Sagan, and let's activate you. Woohoo! Launch the Mars reactor. Perfect. Looking good. Space race project has been completed. Indeed, it has. Indeed, it has. Man, that is awesome. I'm so glad that that is done. The great person was activated, so woohoo, we did it. There is still another bit to go. We really don't need to do any more campus research districts or whatever, because that's just not necessary. Oh, yes it is. Apparently it is. Plus 100% production towards space race projects. I need this. I forgot about the information era, actually. Just give this to me, Arabia, please. Fuck. I don't know if we're going to be able to get enough patronage or enough gold. It's going to be close. Maybe, okay, we're going to keep on building campus research districts. And hope beyond hope that that manages to get us enough gold. All right, we've got destroyers now, which is lovely. I guess we'll form a fleet with these guys because why not? Choose production. What do we care about? Nuclear submarine? Let's get a nuclear submarine. Yeah, fuck it. Let's do it. You are gonna get campus research grants, which sucks that we're doing this, but it's so good. Like, it's such a good bonus for us if we can get it. And I'll get the builder to build on that very, very soon. I really, really, really want 100% production towards space race projects. I really, really, really want it. Like, really, really, really want it. So we're gonna have to save up money, like pretty much money, right? Like that's what we need. All right, you are going to build that there. Sure. Money. Plus 5 gold. Great merchant point per turn. I don't care about great merchant points. I care about money. That's what I care about. Campus research grants. Yes, I know we are definitely capable of building a nuke. But at the same time, I also really, 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 really want plus 100% production towards space race projects. Like, I cannot understate how big that is for us. If we are able to get that. Might declare war in a city-state just for the fuck of it. Just, you know, might be somewhat interesting. There we go. Let's see if we can do any damage to this city-state. It's only got a 7 population. So it's not very much, but it still might be a little bit problematic. Composites, what is this? Modern AT and modern armor. Which requires uranium, I quickly saw. Your power is as fragile as your army is weak. Alright, great. Well, I'm glad that you're so dismissive of me. I love that. That's great. What the fuck is this guy doing? What the fuck is this guy doing? So, thinking about it, right? We've got more chance. I actually think that we can get this.
A fragile kind of strength and a certain inflexible precision.
Lovely. I actually think that we can totally get Stephanie Kwolek. I'm sure that is a famous scientist, and I do apologize, Stephanie Kwolek, if you're watching this, but I don't know how that works. Do not know how that works. Let's get production, I guess. It's probably most worth it. But it's now worth noting that we are super far along the list. Researching robotics and researching nanotechnology, both of which are next, actually. Like, we're super close to nanotechnology and we're also super close to robotics. So we're close on both fronts. Culturally, we're getting a lot of tourists. We got a lot of visitors. A lot of visiting tourists. So we're pretty comfortable with the way that things are going. I think, honestly, we could choose to win either culturally or scientifically.
Have been composed of the hard and solid particles, variously associated with the first. A good navy.
Great.
Is not a provocation to war.
Oh.
It is the surest guarantee of peace.
Well, that's great, isn't it? That's just fantastic. Thank you for those motivational quotes, Mr. Sean Bean. Again, I'm going to set it on campus research grants. I don't care about science. All I care about is the great person points. Amphitheater Art Museum. Art Museum totally gives us the ability to have art. So I was actually right. Archaeological Museum gives us artifact slot. Art Museum gives us art slots. Perfect. We should be able to get that set up quickly so that Vincent van Gogh can go and make his art. That's right. He can go and make it. I'll show myself out, thanks. Yeah. That's about the only thing that we're gonna get any value from. That's about the only place that we could send that envoy that that would get us any value at all. But our great person points, man, it's gonna be close. It's gonna be so close. We get 19 great person points per turn. They get 11. We can either recruit with patronage or recruit with cash, and I don't think that that's going to be possible. Look, I don't want your iron. You're happy to accept that deal? What would you give me? You're not going to give me much gold at all, actually. 4 gold? No. Wow, 1, wow. 4 gold for 30 turns. So you will give me 4 gold for 30 turns. Alright, so it seems that the AI can bargain. But apparently you won't accept it when I offer it. I don't fucking know. Either way, I'm 90% sure that we're going to be able to get this great person. If we keep on saving our cash like we are right now. And I'm pretty certain that our current cash is going to allow us to purchase the great person. It's going to be close. It's going to be very, very close. That's for sure, right? But I'm pretty certain that we can get this last key great scientist. And when I say key, it's very, very key. Let's end the episode when we've got the opportunity to build Operation Thermonuclear War. Because that's a good, fun place to end on. The prospect of thermonuclear war has never been more exciting. Damn right. What is this? There's a ranger over there, so there's a barbarian camp right over yonder. Good thing that we've got mechanized inventory to quickly and efficiently deal with the barbarian threat as it emerges. Wow, I sound like a military general, you know? Brr, deal with the barbarian threat as soon as it emerges. All right. Good stuff, everyone. You, campus research grants. I don't know why it's taken 3 turns now, but hey ho. I think we can totally do it. I think that we can actually totally do it. It's just worth noting, actually, that I will have got 3 great scientists whilst Arabia hasn't even gotten 1 yet, which I find remarkable. So we've got a destroyer fleet. And you over here. What's the range? Range attack is 3. 1, 2, 3. We would deal 90% of the outer defenses, the wall defenses. Might be worth doing, actually. Who is the Surichin? Congo? Congo might come to war with us if we do that. And honestly, I don't value Congo highly as an ally or even as a non-aggressor, but they would probably be able to do a little bit of damage to my city. Especially since we don't have the nuke yet, so we might have to wait for the nuke before we attack this little city-state down there. Either way, we're getting Operation Ivy very, very soon indeed. Pericles, you've thrown away your papers and you've denounced me, you little bastard. That is not so great. That is not so great. What is great, though, is our quest to become the greatest scientific mind that ever ruled the world. Kinda. Also, how is this still not improved? Like, how the hell?
The class struggle necessarily leads to the dictatorship of the
communism. Communism. Karl Marx, one and only. Let's put you guys into sleep. Mechanized inventory. We're gonna head up there. Perfect. The reason that I'm keeping these units here, by the way, is just to make sure that no barbarian camps spawn. Honestly, barbarian camps are more of a threat to my existence than anything else right now. Like, genuinely, they could really slow down my victory. Not like it really... I don't think our victory is anything but confirmed at this point, but it would slow it down a little bit. You are also going to go for campus research grants. Like, this is abusable. Like, this is so unbelievably abusable. This needs to be fixed. It really does. We don't have a campus over here, so we're going to go for an art museum, which is going to allow Vincent van Gogh to do his thing. We did indeed manage to finish Operation Ivy. There was no pomp around it. There was no, like, well, you've completed a nuclear project or whatever. Which kind of sucks, but hey-ho. We've now got the option to build a thermonuclear device. It is slightly more expensive than a nuclear device in terms of production and also in terms of gold as well. It's a little bit annoying there. It's going to take us 14 turns to produce. I'm going to produce one. That is absolutely what I'm going to do. There's a new government available. Communism, really? I don't know if communism is the right 10% bonus to all production. I don't know if that's the right thing for us, but we're gonna leave it there, I think. Yeah, definitely not communism for us, I don't think. We're not really a big fan of that whole communism thing. Didn't really work out, but never know. We could make it work, I guess, if we wanted to, but who even cares? Who even cares? It's not worth it. I'm interested to see what is gonna happen as soon as we... wrong one. As soon as we complete the civics tree, because we're almost there, you know. Like, we are one technology away from just, like, completely finishing it. We've already got globalization. What are you talking about? We've got globalization. Anyway, ladies and gents, we shall continue in the next episode. I do hope that it will be successful. There is a little bit of mechanized inventory from the barbarians coming in, but no matter. It looks like we're actually on course to get the Stephanie Kwolek, or whatever her name is. And with that, fingers crossed, we will be successful in our scientific victory, which is, at this point, looking pretty good. Anyway, ladies and gents, thank you very, very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.